Well, thanks for the question. I'm not too sure how to pronounce the name, Segreta, as it came through from Patrick. Just mentioning how vulnerable this brown snake eagle is, standing out in the open like that on a dead branch, and wondering what the predators are of the birds of prey. And, well, mostly it is other birds of prey. On the ground, of course, it would be any of the smaller predators, any of the cats. Not that likely, though. But pretty much only other birds of prey. I can't think of much that will be eating a brown snake eagle. Having said that, I remember seeing photographs of, I think it was a peregrine falcon, or could have been a lanner falcon, at Victoria Falls, that had struck a black-breasted snake eagle in mid-air, actually struck it so hard that it ripped one of the wings off. And I guess you could say maybe one of the falcons would maybe strike a bird like that. But some of the bigger eagles have other specific prey items. A martial eagle wouldn't really go for it, I don't think. Might, if it was in its territory, it might. I really don't think so, though. But the birds of prey are pretty much at the top of their food chain. Okay, let's move a little bit, see some more of... Well, where did you come from, Mr. G? With two ladies, giraffe earlier, now this big male's arrived on the scene. He must be possibly the father of this little boy. I was going to move, I think I'll just stay here for now. Well, half the drive is gone already and I haven't even found an elephant. Bobby was asking whether this brown snake eagle has a crop, like a bald eagle. All birds have crops. And it's the crop that is the pre-digestion area for birds. Having said that, I don't know how it would work with a snake. Because obviously a snake would be a lot bigger than the crop of an eagle. So maybe it goes straight into the stomach. I don't know. Good question there, Bobby. I mean, birds do have crops. All birds have crops. Maybe this brown snake eagle is going to have the snake dangling out until the first half is digested. Who knows? It'll probably pause and as it is now, and it'll swallow the rest of it a little later. Going to move up towards this junction a little bit away from this giraffe and also not to disturb the eagle, but we're going to take our mid-drive break now in the company of these giraffes, just a little bit away from them that we won't disturb them. And Patrick will take you to Gowrie Dam, and when we open up we'll still be here with the Jerry's Giraffe. Look at that beautiful light on him. That shouldn't disturb them too much where we are now. So, folks, we're going to take a drive break. We'll be back with you in a short while. Don't forget to come back. Oh, sun in my eyes. Welcome back to the Jigger. We are still here at Chelapan. I thought the giraffe might come and drink, and they might just do that. Actually, here we go, madam. Have a drink of water. Right on the edge of the water. Little boy moving through the bush. No, they're moving away. Okay, off we go. We're gonna go through Spaghetti Junction on the other side of the dip. A lovely wild aniseed smell. My word, look at this. We've just turned off the road. Oh no, that's not. I was gonna say there's a snake track over our track, but it's not. Our track's over the snake track. Can you all see that snake track? Yeah, you can see it nicely. Coming from left to right, you can see which way the sand has been pushed on the edge of the S-bends. See how far that snake eagle's got with its snake. I guess, thinking about the whole crop idea, and when vultures and eagles are eating chunks of meat, goes into the crop. But I guess when you swallow something whole, it goes straight down into the gullet, into the, I don't know. Just see how far that snake eagle is. Looks like it's finished. Just a few inches of tail sticking out now. Slowly going down.